Okay. Hello again. The next topic that I want to talk about is file operation. Okay. The next topic is about file operation. So, first of all, okay, let me just change the camera. Here it is. Yes. Good. So first of all, for the file operation, we must know one important thing, which is this way. What is that? File operation. Think about this. You have your project. This is C# project, and you are creating a file, simple file. So from your project, you can access this file two way. What does two way means? Either you can put something into file or you can take something from the file. Okay. So by using C#, you can do a file operation. You can put something into file or you can take something from the file. Normally there are two kind of main files. One is sequential files, sequential access, and the second one is random access files. So sequential access file means that you're starting from the beginning and continuously you are just checking every single byte and you are receiving it. Random access, you are just jumping one point and from that point you are taking some information. Okay, so basically I can say this one, but I'm going to show you just a few basic things. So first of all, this is important. From C# we are going to access a file. So first of all, you must know that the structure of the library of the file is IO, input output. Why? Because we are doing something from outside and it's going to store into memory. Into hard drive. So then it's going to be in the hard drive. So which means that you just, for example, think about this. You play a game, computer games. You are saving your name. And then you are coming to some level. Let's say you came to fifth level. 10 days later, when you come and start the very same game again, 10 days later, it's written on the program, you are in the fifth level. So then normally the program until now that we did, when we turn it off, we have to restart from the very beginning. But how do this game program knows that you are in the fifth level? So your information is stored somewhere in database probably, but in our programming piece here that we are going to learn, you are going to save this information into file. 10 days later when you come, you are going to read from here. Hop, you are going to get the information from the file. So you are in the fifth level. You understand what I mean? So that's why we are storing this information as a file into hard drive. We are not working on the memory only. So then, because we are doing this, we have IO input output library. So without using this input output library, we cannot carry on this file operation because we have some special keywords, special description class or words constructor or whatever it is which is related to file. That's why at the beginning, very beginning, this is the keyword that you must not forget using for the library. You remember that I told you using system.io is our input output library. It should be assigned at the very beginning. Normally, as you may remember, system text, system some other words are written in the piece of program already, but here we have to edit system.io to be able to use input output operation between program and the file. Okay, first of all, in the program you have to use file stream. This is the keyword. This is the class that you are going to create, and you are going to create an fs file stream. Fs is equal to new. Let us understand. It is a class which is file stream, and we are creating an object. What is that? New file stream. What is happening here? In parentheses, you are going to write a construction. I mean, we call it construction overloading. So you do have different possibility. F First thing for the file stream, you are going to put as a text value the path of the file, or in other words, the name of the file is going to be written there. And for example, we put some data dot txt. As you see, it's a data txt is a notepad file. Okay, so you created file stream fs is a variable. So from now on, when we talk about fs, we are talking about data txt. Okay, so then new file stream data txt, so it's a file, name of file, comma, I'm going to put here one important information, because there is no space here, I'm going to write down. What is that? File mode. What are we learning now? Dot, file mode dot, you remember like message box buttons dot, yes, no, cancel, message box buttons dot, okay, message box buttons dot, yes, no, abort, whatever it is, okay? Like this, file mode dot, something is going to written here. This something is showing us what kind of what kind of mode that we are going to use for the file. It is important part. For example, think about a program that we are doing now, and in this program, we don't have any kind of data.txt in our project. There is no data.txt in our project. What do you want to do? First of all, we should create it. Okay, so then file mode, create. Okay, so then this is the first option to be able to write, right? File mode dot create. So when you close the parentheses, what happens here? You just have an fs, which is a variable for you. From this fs, you just create a file stream. The name of file is data txt, file mode create. When you run this line, what's going to happen? As you see on the screen, you just, let's say, press the button. When you press the button, file, the name of file is data.txt created, which is empty, it is notepad file, which is because it is txt. Okay, a notepad file you created. Are you with me? So then to create a new file by using your C#, this is the word that you are going to use. So file stream, coming from the IO library, and you create new file stream, data txt, you gave a name, and your file mode is create. So for the create, you must know that. For example, it's a button. You press here a button, and somehow you did write here some information. Edip, computer, engineer, whatever it is. Okay, you write it here. And after that, if you press same button again, if you press same button again, in other words, if you just run this piece of program one more time, what's going to happen? It's going to create data txt. In other words, this data txt is going to be recreate. So then there will be no information in it. So that's why it's a dangerous mode, this file mode create. If you just by mistake create again and again, if you have 100,000 information in the data text, when you just click, or when you just create the data txt one more time, if you just click one more time, so what's going to happen? All information data txt file is going to be removed. A brand new file is going to be created. Okay, you understand this trend, right? So pay attention, even if there is, I'm just writing here, there is file, if there is data txt, or there isn't. There is not data txt. So then what's going to happen? Brand new data txt created. Do you understand this part? So then to create a file, if there is a file or there is no file, brand new data txt created. So then you must pay attention about this. You must pay attention about this. You do some piece of program here. We will learn. You do some piece of program here. And at the end, after you finish to work with the file, at the end, you should FS. What is FS? FS is our data TXT file. That is like created as a file mode create. FS dot close. What is it? We are closing the file. Closing the file means just we stop working with this FS file. So then in this file, in data TXT, we do have some information. Then we created this file again. There was a file and everything deleted. We have brand new file at the moment. Another one. Here, we don't have any data TXT. We don't have, and we do have a brand new file, which is called data TXT. Again, as I mentioned here, you can write a lot of programming, piece of program here. You did write, it's okay. At the end, we have to close our file. Otherwise, we cannot carry on to work with with our file. So it should be close, okay? So then from this point, after we close the file, we cannot reuse it. To be able to use it again by using file stream, we have to open the file again to be able to use it to write inside something or to read something from the file. Okay, so this is how to use create. So now I'm going to show you all possibilities about file modes. The first one is, as I mentioned, is create. So then this is how you, this is how you create a new file. Now we have another kind of file mode. I will just show you all of them one by one. File mode. The second option is create new. Okay, create new. So then file mode create new. So if you just look at the name, it is similar to create. And for example, filestreamdata.txt, comma, file mode create new that you write. So then there are two possibilities as usual. There is file, let's say, and there is no file. So let's talk about this data TXT. If there is no file, so this is create new, okay? If there is no file, then what happens? What happens? Same as create. Brand new data TXT file is created, okay? If there is data TXT, so now pay attention, we are going to have error message. Okay, so what do we understand? What is the main difference between create and create new? Create, whatever you had, even there is file or there is no file, you are creating a new data TXT. Create new, if there is file, so there is a file. How can you create a new one? You understand what I mean? It's an error. Create new, you are just preparing a brand new, okay? So this is the second option for the file mode. And to create a new, brand new, to create a brand new file, okay? So it didn't finish yet because there are plenty of them. The next one that you must know, again, file mode. And the next file mode is, after create and create new, the next one is we do have open file. So then when you say file mode open, let's talk about again data.txt. Just make logic. Logically just think. So then what is that? I'm just going to put tick and minus. So this is for the if there is file, if there is no file, what happens? If there is file, this, in other words, if there is data.txt, by using file mode open, what's going to happen? You are going to open the existing file. Okay, so then this is the meaning. What about if there is no file? What's going to happen if there is no file? Think about it shortly, slowly, and logically. There is no file, and you are trying to open the file which is not exist. So then it is an error. You understand this part? So then when you just make file mode is open, open file mode, so it's going to be an error. Okay. So it didn't finish yet. The next part, we are going to use file mode again. And the next one I am talking about, open or create. Okay, open or create. So let's talk about it again. So there are two cases. Okay, one is there is file, there is no file. So then you may understand from the name. Let's say we don't have data txt. If there is no data txt, so you are going to create brand new data.txt file. Okay. If there is data.txt, so which means that there is a file and you are going to open the file. Okay, existing file, you are going to open this existing file. So then there is no error here. If the file is not exist, so then you are going to create it because it says open or create. If the file exists, then you are going to open it. Okay. So then these are the important parts that you should know. It didn't finish yet. The next one is file mode. The next one is file mode is append. Append is again same thing. There are two possibilities. There is file, there is no file. I'm going to come back all of those things again. And if there is data.txt, if there is data.txt, it opens without any problem. It opens this data.txt. Okay. If there is no data.txt, it creates brand new data.txt. Can you see any difference between those two? For the file mode, there is no difference. Okay. For the file mode area, there is no difference. But in the next step, I'm going to tell you the main difference. Open or create, you open it if it exists. You open it if it exists. Append, you open it if it exists. So same. Open or create, you create a new, brand new one if it does not exist. Append, file mode append. If file does not exist, you create brand new one. So as you see, both of them are as a behavior of file mode, they are the same. One more thing, which is the last one, file mode. Truncate. There are two options. There is file, there is no file. Okay. So if there is file, for the truncate, if there is file for the truncate, pay attention. This is important for the truncate. If there is file, let's say you do have data.txt and you do have information in it. When you say truncate, it's going to be brand new data.txt. Okay. If there is file, you just recreate it from the very beginning. If there is no file, so then sorry, it's an error. So let us just look at from the very beginning, just to compare each other. Does it look like create? Or let us say this way, what is the difference between truncate and the create? What is the difference between truncate and the create? Look at the truncate. So you're creating a brand new file. If there is a file, you have an error if there is no file. What does create do? You create brand new file in any case. Okay? This is the main difference between truncate and create. Let us talk about open or create. What is the difference between open or create and open? Like this, I think, yes. Open and open or create. Open, if there is a file, you open it. If there is no file, there is an error. Open or create, if there is a file, you open it. If there is no file, you create a brand new one. Okay, So now there is a message. Create will replace the old file with create new. The file must not exist before it is created. Yes, this is what I said. Here it is. Here it is. Create new. If there is a file, if there is a file, there is an error. So you cannot recreate it. If there is no file, you create a new file. Okay, I will make a table for you this one later. Let's talk about append. What is append? If there is a file, it opens. If there is no file, you recreate it. There are like slight differences about this open and close. We will decide while we are running our program. Okay, I will show you all details later. So why they are important? Why they are important? So then mainly we are just using those things. Mainly we are using those things for what? To write or read to or from file, right? For example, let's put this way. For example, if you don't have data.txt, if you don't have data.txt, can you be able to read something from data.txt? It's impossible because it's not available. First of all, you should create it. You can create because look, no data.txt. There is no data.txt, okay? So then these are the options. You can write create. What is it for? To create a new data.txt. This is number one. You can write create new. What is it? To create a new data.txt. So then same way. Okay, next. Can you write open here? No, because there is no file. How can you open? You cannot. Can you write open or create here? Open or create here? It is possible. Because you may remember that if there is no data.txt, you can open or create. Because there is no, you can create it. Create. Okay. And one more thing, append. There is no data.txt and you are using append. What happens? You can create a new data.txt. And the last one, truncate. Can you use truncate here? If there is no data.txt, truncate is giving you error. All right? Why? Because truncate can be used to create if the data.txt available. Okay, let's come back here. If yes, I mean true or available, data.txt. Okay. Okay, next step. Can you be able to use create? Yes, pay attention. When you use create, no problem. You recreate, pay attention, this is important. You can recreate data.txt as num mentioned in the message. What's happening? The old data.txt dies and a new one created as a new data.txt file. Okay, so no problem. So in this two cases, you are going to have brand new one. Pay attention. When you say create new, what's going to happen? If there is no data.txt, it's okay, you can create. But if there is a data.txt, I am sorry, you cannot recreate it. You cannot touch the data.txt. It's an error. What kind of error it is? It is runtime error. So then if you put this sentence, for example, file stream fs is equal to new file stream in parentheses data.txt, comma, file mode create new. If you put in try area, in the catch area, you can say, sorry, file exists. You cannot recreate it. You see? So then this way, you are just giving a message to the user. You don't have any bug. You understand? Good. The next step. This is important. Open or create. I write here. Open or create. I write here. If there is data.txt. If there is no, you are going to create brand new one. If there is means it may have something in it. Pay attention. I am going to draw a picture here. Open or create. Can you write it? Yes. open or create. I write it. And for open and create, the data txt, it is very important to know. And let's say you have here Edip Şenyürek, two words, two text, whatever it is. And I'm going to use another pen to show you. When you open or create, if there is no file, you just recreate it. If you have file, open or create, you opened it and your cursor is here at the moment, okay? Here, at the very beginning of the file, okay? At the very beginning of the file. Next step is coming about append. If there is no data txt, you are creating a brand new one, which is empty. If there is data txt, like here, then you can use append, no problem. And what happens? It also opens the file. Pay attention, for the append is coming. The cursor is here at the moment, at the very end. Okay, have you seen the main difference between those two? Yes, open or create, open coming at the beginning, append coming at the end. Which one is cursor? Okay, next step, the one that we didn't write. For example, open. Can we use open for no data text? No, but if there is, yes. So then I'm writing here. We can use open here. So just guess. If there is a data text txt file, if you use open file mode, what's going to happen? Your file is going to open. Where is your cursor? Your cursor is at the beginning. Okay? So you can guess. Can we use truncate here? If you use truncate, your file opens. How does it open? Remember, how does it open? You are creating brand new, without any information, a new data.txt file. Is this table clear for you? Okay. So then let us carry on. It didn't finish yet. So this is how to access, how to create your, how to make your file mode. So your mode can be create new, open or create, append, open or truncate. So there are six modes for the file. You will decide while you are just making your program, which one you want to use, okay? So then we are going to do examples about it. This is the first case for file mode. Let us remember the code that we wrote. What is that? Remember, file stream, it was fs, is equal to new file stream in parentheses, and the name is data.txt. Sorry. I put comma here. And the first case, I said file mode dot something. Okay, you did create something. You can create new, open or create, append or whatever it is, truncate, open, six modes. Comma. Now a new thing is coming. We are going to learn about, it is very easy, 51270. It is very easy when we do example in the programming laboratory part. Okay, so you will see, it is very easy. Because it's theoretical part, it looks very difficult. The next step, I'm going to create file access. Maybe after this part, you will understand what's happening. File access means you are just accessing the file. Which file? Data.txt file, okay? You are accessing the file. Which file? Data.txt file. There are three possibilities to use this file access. What are they? It can be read. Just guess what is this? To read from the file. It can be, you can guess the second one, write. What is this? To write into file. And the last one is read-write together. It is for to read or write. That's it. Three access possibilities. Now, what am I going to do? to tell you that you must not forget, as I mentioned, after you create the file, you do your programs. At the end, do not forget fs close. You must close the file. Okay. We open the file with the file mode. After that, with the access of any one of them, after that, we close. Okay. We can do some programming inside. We will learn it. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you, I mean, just discuss with you some examples. First of all, let me put this one aside, but I will bring it sometime. First of all, let us create, I will just put all possibilities. File stream fs is equal to new file stream. And the name is, again, look at here, data.txt, comma. Okay, so this part, I am going to put the options, one, two, too many options. Can it be file mode dot, which one we learned first? Look, this is, there is no data.txt file. Let me just show you one file here. Let me just show you one file here. Look, this is the file. Oh, let us make it like much simpler to show you in this on the screen. This is the file, okay? This is data.txt. So, is it visible for you? No, because it says no, right? There is no file at the moment. Can you see here? You cannot see. There is no file here. So, file mode, the first one that we learned. Can I use create? Yes, because there is no file I can create. Question, can I use file access? In other words, when you create this file, can you be able to read the file? Is it possible? You are creating a brand new file, which is here, it came. This is the file. Can you read it? No, because there is no information. You created very new one, okay? It's brand new. That's why with the file access, with the create, file access read is impossible. What can you do? You can create a file and you can start to write something in it, right? This file, you can start to write something in it. So then what happens? You can write it. It's okay. Without any problem, you can write it. Can you be able to read it? I told you, it is impossible, right? Because it's empty. Can you be able to read or write? Because of this word, because of this write word, yes, it is possible. Do you understand what I'm saying? If you are using a new creation, here it is, you create a new file. In with this file, can you be able to write in it? Yes. With this file, can you be able to read or write in it? Yes, because of this write issue, with the create, you can use it. Are you with me? Number two, let's use file mode dot. What was our second one? Create new. Don't forget, create new. Okay. There is no file here, right? Question. What am I going to do? Can you be able to use this create new if there is no file? Yes or no? Remember, if there is no data, just logically think, don't memorize here. Can I create a new file if there is no data? Of course, you're welcome. So that's why you can. So what is your file access for it? Definitely same, because you are creating a new, brand new file and you must write it, okay? Or read write. Can I read the new file that I created? No, you cannot, because there is nothing inside. Are you with me? So that's why this combination is important. So in other words, I'm going to write just down here because this is a useless area. File stream, fs, blah, 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 blah. Look at here, file mode dot, create new, okay, comma, file access dot read. What's going to happen? Straight error. It is impossible. Okay, how can you create a new file and read it? Are you with me? This how Notepad was created. Yes. I mean, Notepad file, not Notepad, Notepad file. When you click save button or when you create, you click a new button, this is how you create. Okay, next one. Number three. So then number three is coming. So we learned about create and create new. There is no file. Don't forget. Can we use file mode? File mode. Open or create? Question. File access. File access. Can it be read? Can it be read? Is it possible? Is it logically okay? Open or create? Don't forget, there is no file. Yes, good. Normally, yes, no problem. You can use read, but there is no file. It is useless to use it. Okay, you can write it, but it is useless to use it. Why? Because there is no file. While there is no file, open create is going to work for the creation. If you create a new file, using read is useless. Understand? Okay, question. File access. Is it possible to use write? Yes, of course, because it can create and you can write something. Okay. Is it possible to use read write? Yes, of course. Okay. So now the thing is that it's important. It is possible to use read, okay? So no problem. Because if there is no file, this is going to work as create and you should use write. So that's why at the beginning of your program code, you must think about should it be write or should it be read or should it be read write, okay? Next part, if there is a file, then it's going to open. You cannot write, but you can read it. I give you a message here. Number four. File mode dot append. Remember, what was it? Append. What is your file access? What is append? Append is used for the writing, okay? So that's why it can be write. Can I read and write? No. Okay, pay attention, this is important. Append is used for write only. So then, can I read it? No, you can use it only for write. Okay, this is the very important part that you must not forget. Append to just update your data, to write some information in it, you are using write. And number five example, because these are finished. If there is file, then file mode dot, let's say open. What is your file access should be? Can I use write? Can I use write? No, it is for read. Okay, you can open the file to read only. Understand? So then these are the two things that you must not forget. You open the file to not write, to read. Okay, this is important. And number six, it is important. If there is a file, your file mode is, generally we don't use it, but sometimes you may need it, truncate. What is truncate? File access can be write again. Why? Think about it. Truncate, if you have a file, you just remove the file. It disappears and you are putting inside some information. So that's why you should write it. So then summarizely, so you can decide at the beginning, you are going to write an information into file or read information from the file. Are you with me? Is that clear? Okay, so then these are the read, write, and the file mode and file access issues for the files. So then this is how we use them. Okay, these are the details that I explained to you. So now let us carry on with the new topic, not new topic, like in the file. The second part. We do have stream. Two different tool. The first one is stream reader The second one is stream writer. Okay. So what is stream reader? What is stream writer? Stream reader, just think like this. Generally, I'm just explaining this way. Let's say this is not this. Let's say this one. This one is a stream reader. Okay. You create the blue pen to read something. So there is a light here, light here. Look what I'm doing here. Starting from the document, I start to read this part. Like a pump, I'm just taking into my stream. Okay, this F, I, whatever it is, there, the, all this line came to my tool. Okay, so it is in here. Which one? The first line that I touch. Do you understand what I mean? So think like this way, logically. So what is this? It is stream reader. And I created a stream writer. Here it is, stream writer. I do have something here. I do have something here already. And when I just touch something, some point here, it just puts all information inside. So this is stream writer. This is stream reader. Do you understand what I mean? Logically, try to understand what I am saying. So now what I'm going to do while I'm creating a stream reader, I write stream reader, for example, SR as a variable is equal to, I say, new stream reader in parentheses. This is important. I am creating a stream reader, which is blue one, to read from which file? From FS. What is FS? The one that I created before. Actually, not created. The one that I created as a variable, like an object. What object is it? It is data.txt. What kind of this data.txt, what kind of file it is? It is created file, it is open or create, it is append, it is open only, it is truncate, whatever it is, okay? So then it is just connected, this stream reader is connected to there, okay? Connected to there. And stream writer SW is equal to new stream writer. Again, I am putting FS. You see, look at the same topic. So then I created a stream writer, which is here. In other words, I just put, like, from here, I'm putting some letters here. After that, I'm going to put this one into FS file. Okay, I can use this pen only for FS file because I defined as this. And after that, I did write some codes here. And at the end of the day, because my task finished, what am I doing now? What am I doing now? I am closing the stream writer. So then I said sw.close. Okay. So what am I doing now with this one? I read it. After that, I did close it. Okay. So then I'm just writing here sr.close. Do you understand what I mean? So then in the file operation, if you open a file, you have to close. If you open a stream reader, you have to close. If you open a stream writer, you have to close as well. I know we just passed 5 minutes, but I need a few more minutes because I must explain one example for each of them. Please pay attention, okay? You can have your lunch a little bit later. So from this point, please look at the program that I'm going to write now. Okay, look at the program that I'm going to write now. First of all, I'm going to show you file stream. File stream FS is equal to new file stream. In parentheses, data.txt. Do we have it? We don't have it. And because we don't have it, I use file instead of using create. I'm going to straight write a code in it, append. And because append, my file access is right. Is this part clear? I use file mode append and my access is right. I am going to write something into data.txt. This way I just created FS. So next step, look at here. I am creating stream, because I use something to write, I need stream writer. SW is equal to new stream writer. What is it? Connected to FS. What's happening here? This FS is this one, this object. And FS opened as append to be able to write. What I am using? I am using a stream writer that I am using here. So what am I going to do? Pay attention here. So stream writer has a word, a special method, stream writer dot write or related to write issue, write line for example, or write, and in as a text met, here I am writing Edip Şenyürek. So my task finished. What is my task? My task to open a file as an append and write line Edip Şenyürek, and my task finish. And what am I going to do? I'm going to close this sw dot close. So my task finish, and I'm going to close this, which is fs close. Okay, so look at here, just piece of code. And I am telling you this is button one. So I click this button one. What happens? Do we have any data txt here? We don't have. So it is creating. Remember append? Append is creating if there is no data txt. So then data.txt created in our hard drive, okay? So next, what is it? File mode append. Remember, we are going to write it. What is file mode append? Our cursor is here, a brand new one. And stream writer, I created stream writer here. So what do I have inside? Inside I put here Edip Şenyürek. Stream writer has Edip Şenyürek and console write line means, where is my cursor? My cursor is here. So then I am putting this Edip Şenyürek into SW. What is SW? Is in FS, so Edip Şenyürek is here. Are you with me? So then this way, when you press this button, you put Edip Şenyürek inside. And because it is console write line, your cursor comes here. And after that, you close your pen. I close it. There is no pen anymore. I mean, no stream writer. And I close the file and I close data.txt. Are you with me? Good. So program is working. This is C sharp. This data.txt is in Notepad. It's created in the hard drive. Program is working. I press button one again, second time. What happens? Let me see. FS. File mode append. Okay, so then we are opening the file. Which file? Data.txt. Is it exist? Yes, it is here. It opened. Do you have information inside? Yes, we do have Edip Şenyürek. You see? And where is my cursor? At the beginning or at the end? Why it is at the end? Remember, I told you here, where is this paper? Too many papers. Here. You may remember here, when you click append, I mean, when you just write append, it goes at the end of the document, right? So then where is it at the moment in this case? Because it is append, it's coming to end. We are here at the moment. Okay, we are here at the moment. SW created again, this pen. Write line Edip Şenyürek. I put inside Edip Şenyürek. Now my duty to put this Edip Şenyürek here. Edip Şenyürek. Why are you putting at the end? Because append is doing that one. You are writing at the end. Okay? After that, you close this button, I mean this pen, and you close the file as well. Next pad, next step. If you click button one more time, what's going to happen? Logically, append, you're coming at the end, writing this right line, which is Edip Şenyürek one more time. Do you understand what I mean? Okay, question. Instead of this Edip Şenyürek fixed, can I take like textbox 1.txt instead of Edip Şenyürek, which means that user can get something, put something here, and it's going to be written here. Understand? This is how you just put information into append. So then from this point, I have button 2. Okay, after that I will finish. After that I have finished, don't worry. What is button 2? Button 2, again, pay attention. File stream fs equal to new file stream in parentheses data.txt. Okay, comma. This time, button 2. File mode, my file mode is going to be open. Do you remember what was open for? You open it and you are going to, what is your file access? You are going to read it. Okay. So I open the file to read something inside. Huh, how am I going to read? I'm going to use my reader. So what is my reader? Remember? Stream reader SR is equal to new stream reader. From which? From FS. FS is here. Okay? Now pay attention. What am I going to do? SR dot, you can guess, if stream writer, you use write line. For stream reader, what are you going to use? Read line. Open close parenthesis, finish. Let us remember. When you just read it, you must use it. What am I going to do? List box 1 dot items dot add in parenthesis stream reader. Do you understand this part? You read the line and put into list box. After that, stream reader, close it. After that, file, close it. Okay? So let's look what's happening. First of all, file stream fs, new file stream data txt. Do we have it? Yes, we do have it. File mode open. Can we open it? Yes, we do. Then we opened. It's opened. Where is the cursor? Remember from the previous picture? Here it is. Remember that? When you just say open, what happens? Your cursor goes at the beginning. So then look at here. It comes to beginning. Your cursor is here because it's open. What am I going to do? Am I going to write something? No, I'm going to read something because access is read. I'm going to read something. After that, I created my stream reader, which is here, stream reader. And after that, this stream reader read line. Read line means read the first line. What do you have here? Edip Şenyürek is here, okay? And after that, after you read that one, you put it in the list box. And here is Edip Şenyürek appears on the list box. After that, you close this one. You couldn't read all of them, okay? You did only first line. You close it and you close it. If you make it, pay attention, if you make it for integer, I is equal to 0, I less than 3, which means that I plus plus. It means that do this 3 times. Am I right? Do this 3 times. What's happening? So it's going to read the first line, put it in the list box, and after that come back, do it again, and this time, because your cursor is from here, look. Your cursor is from here. Read. This is read line. Finish. Then go to next line. This is the second line. Finish. Go to third line and put them on the list box one. So then you will see all of them here. Okay. So but how do you know there are 3 lines in the file? You may not be able to know. That's why you must use something different. Something different. And because of the time concern, I'm going to show this something different in the laboratory side. The keyword is end of stream. Okay, you will learn about this in the laboratory. Just join to laboratory to learn about end of stream case. Okay, I think that's enough for today's lecture. Okay, so with this case, with this examples, you learned how to use, how to make file operations. Okay, how to make file operations. So probably next time, depending on our time, We are just going to make maybe exam. And in laboratory, we are going to make examples to do it. Okay. So when do you think to do exercise better? 15 minutes is not enough for you because you did a lot of things. Let's make it 20 minutes, okay? 20, 25. Is it okay for everybody? 20. Okay. So 20, 25. So 35 to 40, around that. 35, you'll be ready. 40 probably, let's later we are going to start. Okay, see you. See you soon. Goodbye.